Good morning. All right, let's do it again. This is on page 11 on the Bridgman book. Just so you guys know, this video series are just about how I study Bridgman. This is not how you should study, or these are the rules. No, no, no. These are my rules. These are my ways, and I'm just sharing it with you guys. So if you guys want to just watch, you know, what I'm doing, what I'm thinking, this is what works for me. Just so you guys know a little bit about me, I'm an animator. I've been working in the industry for a lot of years. And I'll show you guys my LinkedIn so you guys can see. So the biggest thing with me is there's been a lot of people who teach figure drawing, but they don't got jobs, right? My thing was, I want to know how to do this stuff, but be applicable to a job. Because when people talk about gesture drawing, they'll do it in like an hour. But at work, when you're animating, you got to do it within a couple minutes. So here's my LinkedIn right here. These are my animations when I was in college. So you can go ahead and take a look at my experience. You can see it here. I'm a pixel animator, hand-drawn animator. I do Spine, 3D Studio Max, Flash, and Maya. These are all the game titles that I worked on. Blood Rain, Hotel Transylvania, Silent Hill. It keeps going over here. Shantae, Transformers, Adventure Time, Half-Genie Hero, Shantae, Wonder Momo, Dora the Explorer, Spider-Man. And here's some for Electronic Arts. And where I'm at now. So I'm not just a guy who's just, you know, just drawing. I'm doing this so it can apply to work, so I can be a faster animator, a better illustrator, a better character designer, because that's what I do at work. I'm a character designer, animator. I do everything, wherever they need me, right? And so luck favors the prepared, right? So anyway, thought I'd let you guys all know like where I'm coming from. So when you see these series, like I said, like this is just me, man. Like this is just going down my own little rabbit hole and having fun and sharing it with everyone on the internet. So if you guys like it and enjoy the content, let me know. Like and subscribe. Yeah, if you have any questions, let me know. But there's lots of ways of doing this stuff, right? There's the wrong way, the right way, and the way that I do it. And I'm gonna show everybody the way that I do it and what works for me and what's been working for me for the last 17 years. Okay. Let's see here. All right, so I really like this drawing right here. And as I was saying, I like looking at these small little thumbnails and then just go crazy with them. And the smaller the better, because it makes it more vague. And the vague, as long as it's vague, it's subject to interpretation. So let's go ahead and examine these drawings. And I'm thinking out loud here. I like how this whole thing's a unit. I like how no matter what, when he draws, he always tends to give them like a little bit of hair. I think that's kind of neat because if you just draw like this square, and you know it's supposed to be a person, what better way to really describe that it's a person by just giving a little bit of volume? To know that in the end of the day, even though we're drawing this thing, supposed to be a person. It's kind of neat. I think I practice that. I never really do that. I think I'll adapt to that and see how that works out for me. That's cool. And when I'm drawing, I'm trying to draw like this. Like, I'm trying to bend paper clips. Straight, bend, straight. That's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to avoid drawing in circles like this. I grew up writing writing like this. Sorry, that's a little bad. Hold on, let me do that again. But yeah, I mean, I would sit there and practice this all day. I loved it. I loved doing it. But, you know, I didn't realize, like, I did that in my drawing. So when I tend to draw, naturally I do it like this. Just like the way I write. So you see a lot of, like, curves, you know? So that's my natural tendency. But I'm humbling myself and I want to learn from Bridgman. I want to see what else I can unlock and learn, right? And so the best way for me is to completely mimic what he's doing, which is, he looks like he's drawing with broken paper clip. Look, check it. Like he's bending it with wires or something. And I like it. It's kind of cool. Yeah. So I like trying different ways of drawing. You know, I don't like doing it just one way. I like many ways. I want to see what works for me because I'll find it at times when I'm working on a project. Some of these methods are just more they're just more it's more applicable. You know, I like putting just more tools in my tool belt. That's all. Anyway, just so you guys know what I'm doing, what I'm thinking. There's another one that I like doing. It's called chiseling. It's this. I like doing this a lot. Instead of just whipping through it like this, I like to do this. I got it from animation. A couple of animators do it, and the guys who do it are freaking phenomenal animators. So it's just I looked at their drawings and I thought I'd try it myself, and it's just something that I do. I think I tend to whip out my drawings so quickly. This forces me to savor everything. So even as like I'm thinking quick and thinking fast, this slows me down and makes me realize, hey, this just happened, you know. Savor it, remember it, chisel it in your brain. Call it chiseling. I like doing this just to remind me of like the bones, right? Let's keep going. I don't know why I feel like adding on to this drawing. Let's keep adding on to this drawing. Okay, let's move on. I'm gonna draw that right there. Okay. Let's do one more. Let me save this one. I'll do this one now. All right. I hope this all was helpful. You guys have a nice morning. I'll see you guys later. Until tomorrow. Peace. Oh, and like and subscribe. Thanks.